Hello everyone, John here, and today is a special episode of the Efficiency and Reliability Podcast as I am joined by an industry legend from IGS. While most of you may already know who he is, I'll still give him the floor to introduce himself.
My name's Larry Emch. I'm responsible for the Thermal Efficiency Group at IGS.
Short and sweet. I like that. Thank you for being with us on this episode, Larry. As you know, there has been a lot of discussion about the volatility of gas prices. I believe it's an opportune moment to delve into how IGS is aiding refineries in not only reducing fuel consumption but also lowering their emissions. Is there a recent project in particular that you would like to share with us related to this matter?
I'd like to talk about a steam methane reformer, because I think that's a great heater for a lot of customers. They depend on all that hydrogen production. It's integral to many oil and gas facilities. And actually, when you think about an SMR unit, there's two things that are going on there. Big consumers of fuel, we've got volatile natural gas prices, and in kind, you've got a big contribution to emissions from that very heater operation.
Yes, I agree with that. They are one of the biggest contributors to emissions.
So you've got two things that come into play that make those great candidates, and a lot of customers are focused on that now, especially in their upcoming turnarounds.
Yes.
So we go in as a business model, and we work with the, in this case, the SMR train, the SMR process team, and we go through their operating data. We look at a typical day's production, and we try to capture exactly what they're trying to accomplish with this heater, what their future goals are. And then we take a step back, look at their design specs, any kind of revamp work they may have done, and the gap between what it used to be and what it is today is what they've lost in efficiency. And that is the gap where we try to insert the IGS technologies. We find the best fit for that heater operation so that they can improve the situation on that heater.
How important is it to actually visit the SMR site? Is it truly necessary for projects like this?
SMR units, they have a lot of different designs out there, so it's very important that we go on site and take a good look at exactly the configuration and look at the live process data. So what do we do with all that? We come back to the customer, in this case, that process team, with our recommendations. For this particular heater, it was a fuel savings that was most important to them, coupled with an emission reduction. So it was a 2% fuel savings that we calculated, and they validated that data and how we got to that conclusion.
Okay, 2% doesn't seem high enough. Is it really sufficient to make a significant impact?
Now, if you think about 2%, it doesn't sound like a lot.
Yes.
But when you think about the volume of natural gas that that consumes, it's a big win for that site. So you've got a 2% fuel reduction. Now you've got an equivalent in CO2 reduction. So you're checking great things off on the emission reduction front. Plus, you've got a complementary reduction in NOx. So that was going to be 9%. And you're reducing the bridge wall temperature. In this case, it was 50F. So that whole package, you put in front of the turnaround team, you look at the internal rate of return requirements for that turnaround. Are there enough days? And that's something that we also project. In this case, it was 5 days.
Okay. So, to all our listeners, the packages that IGS provides don't just include the amount, but also the number of days the project will be conducted.
So, that whole package met their investment requirements. They had the days, they had the dollars, and we executed that project. Because the beauty is with C-Tech and Hot Tech and Tube Tech, all the IGS technologies, we're the inventors, we're the owners, we're the developers, and we're the applicators. So we fold in those technologies into how to make that heater the best heater it can be, get it back to design.
Okay, that's a very valid point. I'm aware that many others who offer the same service obtain their technology from suppliers and third parties. With that comes the potential for errors due to the additional processes and steps involved. But, as you mentioned, with IGS, we develop our own technology, which means we have a deep understanding of how to operate it.
So, in addition to looking at the radiant section and the fuel savings from that, we also look at the convection section. Now, an SMR unit, it's really important those convection sections are maintained. You can really lose a lot. You're thinking about process preheat in those units, or even like steam crackers where it's all about crossover temperature, critical to the process. So it's all part of our fired heater team's calculations to fold that in. So there's our recommendation. Our remote operated vehicle technology to bring the convection section back to design. our high emissivity refractory coating to improve that emissivity, re-radiate energy, more energy over design back into the process. So that combination gave them a 9-month payback. Fantastic win. Now we execute the project, we do it safely, we do it on time, we go back in and revalidate all the data from the client, sort that out, and in fact, that's exactly the benefit that they got.
That sounds impressive, not to mention the significant fuel savings they achieve.
They got their payback, they got their fuel savings, which is significant and frankly, sustainable. That's the beauty of the refractory coatings. You're talking about a 2-turnaround run. Think of it as a decade worth of benefit. And that keeps paying for itself, not just in the first year, but every year after that.
I believe that was an excellent project to share. Thank you once again, Larry, for joining us today. I'm aware that you're currently managing several more projects like this, so we won't keep you any longer. I hope all of you enjoyed this special episode. If you'd like to learn more about our other successfully implemented projects, please visit our website at www.integratedglobal.com, where you'll find an extensive library of case studies. Additionally, if you're subscribed to this podcast, we release episodes like this every week, so please stay tuned. If you haven't subscribed yet, you can find us on Spotify, Google Podcasts, and Apple Podcasts to subscribe. Once again, I'm your host, John, and this is the Efficiency and Reliability Podcast. Until next time, have a wonderful day.